we have an opportunity with all of us sitting here to discuss the ecosystem within which we work and where exactly the buck stops. Does it really stop with any one person, or is it a combination of factors and elements that lead to the environment and its being the way it is today?
Earlier, television was a family thing. I mean, I would watch it with my mom, I would watch it with someone else. I knew that there's a show that's going to come today, tomorrow, then on Friday, and then it'll come again on Monday. Or if it was a weekly, then it will come on a certain day, and it was appointment viewing. Today, what has happened is I have content out there. I want to watch it. I will watch it now. If it doesn't engage me within the first two episodes, I'm out.
The problem starts essentially with mindsets. How do we view creativity and creative work? The sad part is, generally, there is an impression amongst most people, because of the lack of definition of an industry, that, oh, creative work is something which is easily dispensable. You know, it's not something which is valued.
You know, before asking for our rights, fighting for our rights, we need to first value ourselves, right?
True.
We need to value what we are creating. We need to know that that is our intellectual property.
A very important part of storytelling is demonstrating how to do it right and how to actually make it happen. So that is fundamental.
There are laws in this country that all of us can avail to, which ensure our rights and civil liberties. Are these laws really the sort that can put things into place and perspective and protect creative communities? Or are they just toothless tigers?
The more we tell stories, the more impact you have. One, building out your reach, getting donors in, and getting more people onto the cause.
The platform is built in a way that the feedback is actually real time. So we do work on a lot of events. We do partner with a lot of media events, etc. Wherein, you know, we use Facebook Live as a medium of kind of reaching out to audiences and all. And the best thing is that we do get to know immediately whether it's working or not because of the comments and the likes and the shares and the engagement that broadly happens on the platform.
There has been some very transformative programs, some critically acclaimed programs, some really controversial programs also.
But that was part of the reason why I threw out my television, because I couldn't bear some fellow turning reportage of real life events into a circus and turning real people into fodder for us to indulge our voyeurism and our sickness in.
I feel in today's day and time, storytellers, content creators are actually kings with a crown of thorns, because there are stakeholders breathing down their necks, also asking them to regulate content.
You are watching a Nagin. You are watching, your husband or your sons might be watching cricket, and therefore you're seeing all the ads that come in cricket, which are completely different. So what does that do to a human mind if you are like, you know, if you belong to a category which is Nagin, but main ye sab bhi dekh rahi hu. So what happens to me?
Do we have the systems in existence where an individual, without having to throw up everything into the air, including their work, and fight the legal system or fight the existing systems? Do we have that kind of a structure in place? And if we don't, what is it that we need to do to bring it into place?
Is that our definition of success has become that a film is successful only if it makes 100 or 200 or, you know, 50,000 crores or whatever the absurd amount may be. But even today, if you talk to a person outside of India, or even India, but definitely outside of India, the only person they know of is Satyajit Ray. And none of his films made even the, you know, pre-inflation amount of 100 crores. Not one of them. Today, if you talk to anybody in Bombay, they will talk about Satyadev Dubey as being the doyen of Indian theatre. And I have seen a play of his in which there were five people, you know, and he went ahead and did. So what is our definition of success?
Ratings and analytics, it's just a sort of feedback mechanism, and we sort of just report what is being consumed. So which comes pretty much at the end of the entire thing. So according to me, I think there is no one single person who is really responsible, and everything has a part to play in the process.
What we really need to do is have a compendium, like how the current new government has said that the labor laws should be brought under one roof. I think the time has come where for the media and entertainment laws to be brought under one particular
I don't think as a practitioner that one can set out with deciding whether one wants to be a messenger or an entertainer. It is something, firstly, which is very individualistic. It's a choice. And secondly, it has to come naturally.
Debates don't give us news. No matter which way you think about it, debates just end up confusing us and they no longer even entertain us. But I think that the debate structure has gotten so popular because as viewers, I think Indian viewers are among the laziest in the world.
The reason why we are having this discussion is that we obviously haven't created the world that we want our children to live in on screen.
There are people doing amazing things. Like just this morning, I read an amazing piece by Rukmini S, who does data journalism about women and public transport and the manner in which women are using public transport. And I can think of 20 narrative stories one could make from that kind of journalism. But you needed that journalism to happen. It does happen. So I feel we're all a bit too caught up in decrying what we don't like and not celebrating the things that we do like. So if we want the world to change, we have to say, hey, I love this thing. And I'm going to talk only about this. I mean, we are 20 people. We have the luxury to talk about the things we adore right now.
When we look at for cinema as an art, then there is like this auteur theory where the director and the writer, they create some sort of a vision, which is so unique. Like Budapest Hotel ले लीजिए या फिर Martin Scorsese का काम काम ले लीजिए या फिर we are मतलब वो इतने दूर के पल्ले हैं ना तो वहाँ पे मतलब जाने का तो कभी मौका ही नहीं मिलता हम लोग यहीं अटके पड़े हैं and with the times जो politically voice एक अपनी आपकी आनी चाहिए वो भी हमें नहीं मिल रही है because we are faced with the constant insecurities and intolerance and impatience on all three levels.
Someone doing domestic work can be treated as somebody who is doing a job, and it could be treated as someone who is basically in a master-slave relationship with the family.
If tomorrow UNICEF is doing an event and they want their partners to understand how they can leverage Facebook organically, we step in and we have this customized workshop material which basically makes you understand the basics of the platform and how you can scale yourself, collaborate a lot more across.
How do I as an individual fight against someone, a big corporation who's infringing on my work or someone who's ripped off my work completely? There are criminal provisions that you can use to your advantage also. That's how you make the system work.
We believe that there's a huge amount of shame not only around talking about sex, but a lot of shame about not having sex, about feeling you're not cool enough.
I really think that you are storytellers with a purpose. And a good story always has a message.
These little things, messages that are coming in ads which are gender positive and oh, which is such a great, like in the Havel ad, oh, the man made cook something, or oh, he washed, so we should be, no, I find it demeaning. I'm a filmmaker. As a filmmaker, I've lost work because I've refused to do certain ads because I don't agree with the script, I don't agree with the copywriter, I don't agree with the stance of the company.
Public funding mechanism in India, we don't have any government fund which most of the country in the world have. That gives you flexibility in terms of choice of content you want to create. If it's a private funding, it's a commercial decision. You look at, if I put in X amount of money, how do I get that back and how do I get more out of that? So honestly, to blame a producer that he is backing a wrong content probably is not justified. But the fact remains that more the risk, you become less creative. Then you try and do things which are not out of the box. I worry more about my investment rather than looking at what I'm making. Will it work? That's the only question I ask myself. Is it good? That's second.
I feel one of the problems we have today is that only one kind of story has become what is acceptable as a selling story. And I think we haven't made the effort to find new sales points in the market. I think we've not made the effort to say other things can sell too. Just invest in it or find more inventive or more aesthetic ways of telling a story.
How do you get a break? How do you go out? How do you sell your film? How do you get a producer to have confidence in you for the first time when you're in the market? Javed Sahab ki film to koi bhi le lega because he is Javed Sahab. But to get there, how do you get there? It's a challenge.
First, as a writer, I never try to entertain. I always try to put issues across the table by engaging.
When we did an analysis, we found that men were shown cooking in the kitchen
when it came to smart gadget.
Why are you being so kind to the men? Why can't they be making the puri?
जो एक कारीगर जिसने ताजमहल बनाया होगा, कुछ ऐसा नुक्स अगर उन्होंने छोटा सा रह गया होगा, तो वही उसको ठीक कर सकते हैं. इसीलिए तो हम एक्सपर्ट हैं ना. आपका एक फंक्शन है, हमारा एक फंक्शन है. Give us that much respect.
All our partners, we do provide analytics support. So you have a lot of audience on the page, but the engagement is still dropping. What could be the reason? Should you be posting content on a particular time of the day? Should you be targeting your content to a particular age group? So we apart from guiding you on the best practices, we also have analytics support which plugs in
all the amendments that Mr. Javed Akhtar and all those lyricists, authors, all of them fought for, and two notifications they've all taken back. So we're great at saying recognizes an industry. To me, recognizes an industry doesn't mean giving a flower pot to all the top five male Bollywood actors in a room and recognizing you as an industry.
मैं एक फिल्म की सक्सेस पार्टी में बैठा था, नया था यहाँ पर. सो मेरे बगल में एक बड़े स्टार सेक्रेटरी थे, बैठे हुए थे. उन्हें एक फोन आया और फोन उन्होंने रखा. हाँ जी जी सर जी सर. रख दिया और हंसने लगे. मैंने कहा सर क्या हुआ? बोले नहीं, वो अभी मैं जिस एक्ट्रेस को मैनेज करता हूँ वो और एक बड़ा हीरो, मैं नाम नहीं ले रहा हूँ जानबूझ के, अभी हम आउटडोर गए थे फॉरेन लोकेशन पे, 5 गाने शूट करके आए हैं, तो अभी डायरेक्टर साहब का फोन आया था कि भाई अभी स्टोरी मिल गई है, जमा के शूट करते हैं. सो फॉरगेट अबाउट प्रिजर्विंग द वॉइस ऑफ द स्टोरी टेलर. हाउ डू यू प्रिजर्व योर सैनिटी इन दिस काइंड ऑफ एन एनवायरनमेंट?
वन ऑफ द फैक्टर्स कंट्रीब्यूटिंग टू दिस लेजीनेस इज द ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ डेटा दैट इज एडेड टू द इंटरनेट एवरी डे. नाउ दिस कुड बी अ मिटिगेटिंग सर्कमस्टेंस. एवरी डे 2.5 quintillion bytes of data are added to the net. There are 1.2 million terabytes of news, of information, of data, of pictures. And it goes on. And it's just going to get bigger and bigger. Who is going to curate this stuff? Who is going to ensure that what you see of the internet in terms of news is what is really happening?